Okay, welcome to part two of this tour thing of my world. And so last time I showed off my build, like my starting builds, right? My survival build stuff, my first creative builds. But now I'm going to take you along this road here, and that leads to my first sort of masterpiece, if you will. But I'll hit some stops along the way. First one here is what I call Fibre del Hueso, which is modeled after a typical Western town. It's along this road. This is supposed to be a stagecoach. You got all the necessities. Here you go. You got the mayor's office, the bank, the salon, or saloon, whatever, the sheriff, and the coffin shop. Of course, these are supposed to be coffins. I always use double-chest as coffins. And this was made after a lot of stuff that I'll show you later. I just got bored one night and built the whole thing. And this is the giant cemetery. And this is the first, second graveyard in the game, in this world, that I'll be showing you out of I don't know how many, but there's a lot. Anyways, I'm going to kind of keep my head down because I don't want anybody catching any premature glimpses of my first favorite place. But, got my complicated diagonal bridge. This is actually a pain to build. Don't like building diagonally much in this game. Quickly show you through this. I think I called this place Crescent River. And I actually like it. It's kind of bio-y. I really like this, bridge here. Works well. And, just a bunch of little houses on the river. I like that. But what I'm going to do, you can kind of see what I'm going to show you right now. I was going to fly to a better vantage point of it and hope it doesn't lag out. This here is what I call Regius, which is the first city I built in this world out of two. Well, unless you include Treetop City. So it's going to lag a bit because it's a big city. So, oh god. Just wait for everything loaded. So there's ships I build here. You got your windmills. And here's the city. I'll take you through this first. And the centerpiece should be spawning in at some point. You'll probably see that. But there you go. It's going slowly. Anyways, here's the docks, first of all. And I worked really hard on like editing both the interiors and the exteriors here. And I put a bunch of parks. I tried to make it look like a big trading zone. And it worked pretty well. I'd say these houses are a bit too close to the docks to be useful. Down here, just going to show real quick, I have a boat that goes to Landria Town from here. So I used that a lot once I installed it. This dog I gave a name, I thought. No, I didn't. Here's the boat yards. Make boats there. I'm actually going to quickly show you this boat because it's kind of interesting. This one is the biggest boat on this side of the city, and it's like almost completely swamped because I kind of screwed up on making it. Actually, I'm going to probably be showing you some darker things pretty soon, so I'm going to grab a night vision potion. Here we go. So, as you can see, it's just pretty, like, the hull looks good, but it's just almost swamped, so, kind of screwed up there. Here's a crane I built. I like the look of this crane. Or, oh, wait, no, that's not the crane. This is a, wrecked ship. Crashed. Here's the crane. I think it looks cool. What do you think? If you don't, screw it then. But yeah, I tried to make, basically, this started my, sort of impasse between my desire to make everything seem. I wanted everything to seem. What's the word I'm looking for? I wanted it to seem usable, like as if you were playing in survivor mode. So, like, you could use all these buildings. But also, like, they can't be as extremely epic as you might want them. Otherwise, they won't be very usable. Like, eventually, I found a good equilibrium, but Here I was focusing quite a bit on making it still usable, and this is what you're left with. It's still cool, I'm very proud of it still. But I made this, like, I stopped playing, so maybe I built this in grade 8 or something? Anyways, so over here's the industrial side of town, just a few chimneys and stuff. And here's a park. I like this park. Not really. Screw it then. But there's a bunch of industrial stuff. This is my first attempt at vines, because I think I was in Italy and France when I was making parts of this city, so I probably added that in then. There's a bunch of burnt up homes, as if a stupid dog, as if a fire blew through. And here's a chiseled quartz. The idea is a sculptor lives here. I don't want to take too long, because this is a big city. Here's a bridge. Here's the another idea. Once these horses came out, I made a lot of them, and like I named them guard horses. I bred mules and donkeys, and I tried to make them like slave horses or something. Try to make them look like they were being used in the city, but they eventually just threw off their leashes and they just got themselves swamped in there. So good for them. Here, I made another graveyard, and this is just a small one. I'm actually going to quickly address how I built these cities. In all of them, they're on the coast, and they rise up a little bit. I saw this once, and like I never stopped doing it. But so they're all flat. There's no hills or anything in the cities, because they're all just risen up a little bit. So you'll notice that there's no hills or nothing. Here, that's supposed to open, and like traders could come through here, even though I have no idea how they could get past this crap. Anyways, I'm taking a bit long here, so what I'm going to do is address this thing here, which I believe I called... Oh, I had a name for this cathedral. Oh, I know where I can find it. In the library, which I think is this building. Yeah, I named it Regius History Ventibus, and that's like the fake religion I came up with this. Okay, so right now what we're going through, this place is divided into four districts. Right now we're in the middle district, which is like, because this is where like the middle class lives. Yeah, I think that's what I called it. And basically the idea with this, I created like a huge lore about this city. Basically like, settlers came here, they named it Phantom, then like two other idiots came around, they stole the city back, named it Regius. Anyways, I'll flip through this book. Okay, Phantomians. Domus Vitae. That's the Domus Vitae, which I think means like House of Life or something. You'll notice that in a lot of these original builds, or a lot of these early builds, I named a lot of stuff off Latin. Like Regius, I think, means royal in Latin. And Domus Vitae is like House of Life. And you can thank Google Translate for all that. Anyways, I'll go check out the Domus Vitae. But first of all, they got the graveyard with all the horses in it for some reason. The guard horse just hanging out in the graveyard. Yeah, I made a bunch of guard horses, and I'm not sure what good they would be because they just stand around with nobody on them. So that's the Tumbus Canal. I think that thing I just showed you there, that right there is the Tumbus Canal. Anyways, I'm going to show you through here. It's sort of based off that one Paris one. How could I forget that, the name of it? But I have. But, it's really dark in here, so I'm actually going to down one of these. And this is what you got. You got these rafters up here, which you have no way of legitimately getting to. I considered making nice murals on the top, but it didn't really work, so eventually I just settled for stained glass patterns to make it look churchy. But yeah, this is like the biggest thing I had made up to this point, and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. Here's the one mural I attempted. I think that's like supposed to be heaven or something. There's hell and there's like fire and clouds or whatever. Or maybe day and night. I'm not sure. There's a side door that doesn't work at all. And basically, I figured I might as well give this place a point, so I threw in a legendary sword or whatever. Oh crap, I'm getting some lag, so I apologize if that irritates you. I like this floor pattern. I'm actually really happy about this. Yeah, this is the first time I think I tried using like any really complex floor patterns. Like, look at that. That actually looks awesome. I never even looked at this before. That looks great. Patting myself on the back, I'm sorry. But I used all these stairs to make complex floor patterns here. But later I switched to other things in a different cathedral, which I'll show probably in the video after this. I apologize if these are huge videos, but I think I'll also make brief, like, flyover videos, just quick tours showing it. That's the crypts. In case you didn't notice, I just felt the need to use all those skulls. That's a big statue. I came up with all these fake gods, too. And, like, I gave them a bunch of statues and stuff. And I tried to justify putting all these crosses on my churches and stuff, because I pretend like a god was usually depicted like this, because I'm trying not to make any like real religion in here. From here you can actually see the rest of the city, so in case you wanted a better idea of how big it was, there you go. So, where am I going to take you next? Here's a third graveyard in the middle district here. And I'll address why I call these all different, you know, middle, upper, lower, shadow, once I reach the castle at the end. So, this is the Hourglass Fountain, which I'm kind of proud of because I think it looks cool. Man, I'm starting to sound like Beavis and Butthead, man, aren't I? I can't do a good impression while I'm sick. Right here, I just want to point out like these old, I use quartz here, I make some nice runes, I think they look okay. This was supposed to be the original flag of like the first colony, whatever I called it. I figured I just wanted a flag there, and I eventually... Basically, how I made this city is I started from here, right? So I first made the middle district, then I made the upper district, then I think that I moved on to the castle, and then I made the lower district there, and then all the stuff over there. Like, this is huge, hugely compacted, this city. I just want to give a nice view of it. Like, it's big. I have no idea how I had all this time. You know, I'll take you through the farms just real quick. So, of course, got my sunflowers, got my vineyards, got my wheat. I really like the look of these windmills, although I added them in later. Like, I built the farm, then I finished the city, and these were added in much later. But, I really like the way they look. And, over there's some mines. I'm not going to go over there because it's not too interesting. And basically, like, this is a shipping river, but I call it a canal even though it's not. Here's the nice old... I love making water wheels because they look cool. But with these stairs, they've always irritated me because underwater, it doesn't fill this one gap here, so it just looks dumb. But this one... Yeah, it's okay looking water wheel. I might as well take you through the Shadow District. This I added like after everything else was done. I just got bored one night, turned on the eagles, and built this. Yeah, this marks a point in time which I started listening to a lot of music while I was building. So it all became like... It's all kind of connected to the music I was listening to. So this one I distinctly remember listening to the album one of these knights while building this district. And this is supposed to be like a huge poor man's district, right? Bunch of crap, bunch of all these old shanty homes, really crappy. There's like, at night, it actually, I'll show you the whole city at night once I'm done with the tour. I think this one video is just going to be all about Regius because it's so big. Yeah. Where was I? There's the new flag. The new flag I made off about this city has blue, green, and orange. And you can see it in a lot of... God, that dog! A lot more crap. Basically, they need to get their water from here, their fresh water. They bottle it up into, like, nasty stuff. Once I'm done showing you, I'll read the book about it. Just quickly skim through, I guess. Down here, I made a sort of thief hideout. Or, like, a guild or whatever. A lot of this crap actually is inspired by, like, the Elder Scrolls. A lot of my builds, so... Mostly Skyrim, because that's the one I played the most. But yeah, there you go. So I came up with this design for these shanty houses, right? But then I got bored of it, so I started experimenting with these tents made out of sails. This is cool, because there's like an old beat-up ship they're all living in. What else about this place? I'll just show you this temple. Basically, the idea is, like, with the Shadow District, there's a bunch of, dicks from a, fake... Okay, I'll talk about this now. Basically, I have this world, right? In case you haven't noticed. And, two of these countries I made up are, like, part of one big, huge, continent I think I called Sutrim. This is just all, like, fantasy in my mind. And I wrote it down a couple places, but... Basically, up north, that's north, you got a place called Norain. And the idea is, they had a big, like, blizzard or hurricane or something. And they all got driven down here. But they're all poor, because they're refugees, so they have to build up this Shadow District. And it's technically not a part of the city. So I'm just going to quickly skim over it. Just pause if you want to see. There's probably a bunch of spelling mistakes, but that's like the lore I came up for this place. And basically, these Noranians, as I call them, they all live in this giant old... Or they worship this giant old... temple. Yeah. So... just to give you context, have I already? This was the last part of the city I built, this Shadow District. But now I'm going to move on to the Upper District. And this is where you start seeing the like royalness of it. And as you can see, it's gotten a lot laggier because of all the stuff that's in this place. So I'm not going to go into any of these buildings because they're all pretty pointless. But here's a big square. You got your big, this is just the grand, what do they call it, Main Street. That dog's gonna be barking all day. That dog will die someday, and when I do that, I'm gonna party hard. But I digress. There's the actual entrance. This is like the only entrance to the city I made. Well, there's two, but this is the main entrance. It comes from the jungle, enters. You got the bank. This bank's nice, because I'll quickly show you the mural I made. I really like that mural. I think, like, out of all the murals I made in this game, I think that's the best looking one. One of the best. Because I haven't shown you other things yet. Whew, really giving my voice a run for my money, man. Here's an opera house. I'm just showing you these really big centers of... like focuses of the town, city, whatever. Yeah, the opera house, a nice little background, fake trees. The curtains look good, but there's not many seating places here, so sucks for these guys. Sorry about the lag. It's perfectly okay until I get into one of the cities. Sun's going, nope. I'm just gonna quickly show this. This is also just, it's kind of tucked away, but it's got all the flags, so it's supposed to be like the embassy of the other countries in this place. So it's really small inside, so there's no way you could fit many people in anyways. And here's, of course, some of the toilets. Always got it. I always felt that was a focus. Give them places to crap. Here's a fountain. It's a nice looking fountain, actually. It's kind of tucked away, though. There's more toilets on this side. And you know, since it's so well lit here, I'll let this drift in the nighttime until I go to the castle. Yep, toilets. Toilets galore. I think the final centerpiece of the upper district here is the Greyhound Square, as I call it. And I built this once they added the horses in. So it's just like a horse racing track, and here's a... You're supposed to be able to joust here. I'll just ride Alice and show it. So that's like the jousting border. So it must be grade 8 that I built all this. Because I remember jousting was something I found out a lot more about in grade 8. These were all wool for a long time. These banners. But once the banners came out, like, I had all these fake banners set up anyway, so I replaced them all. And they look good, man. So, of course, like, this one looks more realistic than this. But I was starting to run out of things to do. So, yeah, it's kind of based on, what do they call it? Sicily? There's, like, that one town in Italy that has, like, horse races, and they have all these banners and crap. But, yeah, I tried to be as creative as I could, but, like, stuff like that, that's really simple. And, of course, you just got the Pink Floyd one here. That's, believe it or not, that's my favorite band. I listened to Dicks out of them when I, while I was building all this. But believe it or not, that's like the only reference to them I made in the whole world. I just want to show these statues because I think they're interesting. All the quartz. What the... Oh, wait, this is part jungle. This upper district. So all these ocelots still spawn in. And I like to think they're the stray cats. So they kind of add a bit of atmosphere. Oh, that's a nice looking moon. Anyways, there's your crap. I just want to run down this street because it looks cool too. There's so much lag in this part of town, but I can't help it. Because I'm not buying a better computer. Anyways, let's give you a bird's eye view of the place. The upper district. And I'll, or higher, this is called. It's upper or higher. I never really decide. Just skip over this so you can read it up. Man, I put so much work into this. I've never shown it to anybody until today. And I really hope the recording doesn't screw up, because then I'll probably piss myself. Whew. Anyways, I'm going to set it to day, show you the castle. And this is the castle with the... it's the colorful castle. That's kind of the idea I wanted to make with it. Like, you see all these castles with, like... I'm going to position myself here, but there's so many cords... You see all these castles, right? And they're all just gray. They're all, like, foreboding. I wanted to make mine look really colorful with the main colors of the flag that I decided on. So there you go. That's what I came up with. And basically, it's got the pointless moat. I like the way these two pathways look, because they lead around to actually some pretty nice places. These are only gardens that the castle has. But you got these stones. I actually really like this area. I'm going to show you the bird's eye of this. This is the biggest flag. Or is it the second biggest? This is the design of the flag. You just got like that Roman numerals 2. There's no particular reason I made it that symbol, other than it was easy to make in blocks. And then you got all the smaller ones. Yeah, the roof's just kind of like, there aren't actually any fireplaces in the place. It just, it needed crap to look nice. And basically on all the wings of this, it's got these domes of the colors of the flag. And pretty much, it's built on top of this river here. So if you actually drill underneath the castle, there'll be a river. And I'll show you inside now. You got the nice velvet rug. But yeah, here's like the best staircase I've ever made. I'm just really proud of that. Like, of course, up here, I couldn't really think of any way to go to the third floor. But, that's the best staircase I've ever made. I eventually came up with a different design of staircase. It's more of a spiral staircase, but the castle needed a professionally done staircase. So there you go. But over here, basically all these wings with the domes, they're supposed to be different aspects of the government. So I definitely built this castle in grade 9 then. See? I remember all this stuff. So this is like the Senate or somebody, like a council of some sort. Over in this other room, you have like the executive judicial part of the court or whatever. It's where all the nasty old judges sit. I try to give them all chandeliers. Well, no. I forgot what I was going to say. I admit. But there's the dome. So this one's the red dome. I think the one over there's the green dome. They're made out of the ruby emerald and a redstone emerald and diamond blocks. And this is the blue dome. And this is where like the kingly king sits and all of his friggin' moochers. Yeah, and the color of these walls are always the color of the dome. Whereas in the main castle body, it's all blue, green, and orange. And right here is kind of one of the most important rooms. That's the whole map of what I call the Terra. So, just to give you an idea, here's Scuba Town. That's where I started in the last video. There's Treetop City. Then there's Creative City over here, and the Sheena Village is that one village I showed you at the end there. There's the Alandria Town, Fibre del Hueso, and of course here's the East Harbor, the Middle District, the Shadow District should be there. A lot of this was hard to name. There's the Upper District and the Castle of Regius, and there's the Middle District, Lower District you'll see in a while, and the Regius University I'll show you in a while. And then probably going to need to do 2 more videos of this stuff. Down there, I'll show you later. Herobrine's Rift, you've heard of that. Metacresta, Autumndale. Man, why did I decide to do this all in one sitting? Basically, I just want to point out some of the interesting parts of the city is you got... It sort of forms like a urban wall between this huge little it's not called an arpeggio, that's a music term, archipelago or something, this little island stretch. And I didn't plan it that way, it just happens to look that cool. Anyways, that's about all I'm gonna show for the castle. I'll quickly take you up to the leg's getting hard. Quickly take you to the kingly bed and the another unopenable door, which I'll just break down and get through, and the kingly dining room with another mural. Okay, time to break down this door. Come on. Oh boy. Now, do I have a different... No, I don't have anything written about the castle. Okay. And then finally, well, secondly, you have the lower district. And this part, talking's taking a toll. This district's interesting because I have it organized that there's two types of architecture here. There's based off Parisian architecture and Venetian. Like, that's based on Venice, that's based on Paris. And I just have it completely split in two by this canal. And whereas Like the upper district's perfectly square because it's always because it's got the walls, and it would be hard to make them diagonal. The middle district's all friggy, and this one's just a complete straight shot to another harbor there. And that's one of the interesting aspects of this city, is that they got two different harbors. And as you can see in the map, or could have seen, it's all connected, the seas. So I'm not going to go through much of this. I'm going to point out some interesting locations. I'm just going to kind of do a brief skim. So that's the Parisian side. And I'll point out some of the interesting parts of it. Right about now, actually. Okay, so there's two interesting parts of the Parisian side. Number one is you got the black market here. And every city's got to have a black market, so there you go. And basically, the idea with this is that they got a secret entrance from the canal through this grate here. So, yeah, a lot of shady stuff I added too. Didn't want to make utopias. Definitely wanted them to seem alive. And of course, when you have crime, you gotta have the fuzz. So right here is the headquarters of the LEER, the Law Enforcement Agency of Regius, and that just happens to sound like Lear, so it's cool. They got their police horses. Not sure what they're gonna be policing stuck up in this ken. Ken? Kennel. Okay. Oh my God. Starting to take its toll. Taking a tour of this place. Here you got an office. I think it's chief office or something. I'm gonna quickly take you through this. It's an iron door here, so what you have to do is when there's no secretary working, which there never is because it's a single player, you gotta pull that. And there you got like archives. I'm just gonna quickly take you through the floors. You got the municipal jail. So that's like the only jail in here, so there's obviously not too much crime because that's the only jail. You got the patrol division. So this is actually kind of based on LA Noir, not gonna lie. Vice division. And you got the homicide division. And after playing LA Noir, I decided it was a cool idea to give myself a police office. And I set up this thing. And it's kind of like, what would they call it? Like a clipboard. It's tracking the crimes of this guy called Blood King 301. And in case that sounds like a Minecraft username, it's because it is. It's my buddy Jim's, who you know as the person who hates Shrek's Carnival Craze. But there you go. He hated the victim, has access, and can murder. Jim. My good friend Jim. But screw him. He's apparently in this world somewhere, and I gotta apparently become a detective and take him down. So that's good. It's good friendship. Oh boy. Okay, I'm gonna get out of here and show you the Venetian side, because I got a feeling I'm gonna make some huge videos. They are gonna be big. I just need to show this before, like, because if I die, it'll just be thrown out. I need to get it like on the internet or something. Okay, interesting aspects. There's about two, no, three on this side. I already showed you the really quickly the graveyard that's on this side. I have another small church that I threw in on this side. So, yeah, just brief little, just a little church. I call it the Church of the Hero because I made up a fake religion again. Made up like six fake religions. I don't know why. I'm not religious. I'm an atheist. So I don't know. Where's the? Yeah, and here, you know, I built the huge city, right? But up until here, I didn't give myself a anything resembling a house or anything in the city. Because I don't really like the city. I don't know why I built two huge ones. As you got another. Actually, this map existed before the Shadow District was built, so you can see it from here without the Shadow District. Yeah, so I gave myself this just tiny little apartment. You got Scuba Town there. Got the maps going. Here is actually a secret. That will probably be the last thing I'll show you, because I feel that was very well hidden. And, well, that's about it. Just a little city I gave myself. A little city I gave myself. A little apartment in the city I gave myself. Second thing, part of this. First of all, I like this house because it's got courtyard. And this is the market here. Just a little market. I thought it would be cool. Right? Like, is that obviously a market? I wouldn't know. Nobody's gonna tell me either, so whatever. And here's a bunch more ships. Gave this one pink sails, so obviously it's the party boat. This one. I did have this flag a lot of the bear on the green and the gray, although it doesn't actually exist to anything in my lore anymore, so just a flag. I'll take you through the mastership, which of course is this. Let's set it to day so you can see it. That is a man of war, and I called it SS McCarley. I had to chop down an island just so it fits in next to it. But it's big, man. Like, that's. I can't make a ship that looks as good as this. I even gave it the balconies on the back. See, SS McCarley. And yeah, I played Assassin's Creed 4. I'm like, huh. I can make a man of war in Minecraft. And there you go. I gave it, like, everything, man. The difference between Regius and some later things I'll show you is that every interior is designed, right? Everything has stuff in it. Like, here's the cannons, and there's beds, and there's crew bunks. I'm not gonna take you through it because it's a big ship. But yeah, I'm just gonna show you one more thing. I'll show you that in the next video because that's actually one of the more recent builds I did. This is the last part of Regius over here. And I'm just going to show you how you're supposed to get to it. So, at this rear road in the lower district, you got a bridge on the outside. Takes you down. And you just follow the road. I wish you could do it faster. Actually, I can't. I'll just fly. And it takes you to the University of Regius. And I just figured, like, I didn't put any, education or anything in the city, so I figured, well, there you go. There's your university, and you got everything you'll need. You got your dried up fountain, which is cool. You got your library hall, and your classrooms. I think, yeah, some of the classrooms are empty. I haven't fixed that yet. You got the clock. I like the way that clock looks. That's one of two clocks in the game, I think. What the? Anyways, there's. The inside of this looks nice because it's got murals. I like making murals, but sometimes they're very hard to do. As you can see. And then you just have dormitories here. So that's the university. I mean, not much to it. Just kind of over here in the big snowy Alps, whatever. Right here. Actually, interestingly, you'll notice that it's all grass just for one line. And I have no idea what caused that to happen, but it's kind of cool, so I named it the division line. And with that's Regius, the first city I built out of two. In the next video, I'll show you, starting with this over here, some of the last few things before I get to my second city, which I just called Rhodes. So, hopefully, if that seems interesting enough, then stick around.